Hello everyone, my name is Kamran Tami from SimplifySerial.com. This is my new course about GUI development in Python. We will use in this course tool which is name of WXPython. This tool is very powerful in creating simple apps, but you can also build very scalable large apps using WXPython. The most important advantage is creating apps using the approach of object-oriented, so you can save time on large apps by reuse some of your code. Before you start coding using this library, you should note that this library isn't built in by default in Python, so you should install it. In your command line, you can type bib install wxpython, and that if you have the network activated in your PC or laptop, you should download this library. After downloading and activating this library, I'm using personally Python version 2 and library of wxpython version 3. To follow along on this tutorial, you should install Python 2.7 and WXPython library version 3. We will start building our first app. So now we are going to build our first app. Our first app will be simple. It's just a message that displayed to the viewer. So our app will contain three lines or three parts. First part is the import. We will type here command, which is comment. First, we'll save this in this directory as 1.py file. First is the comment, first part of our app is import from library. So we will import WX. Second part will be our app or our class. So as I have mentioned earlier, we will depend on object-oriented approach. So if we want or you hope to build very large scale app, you should use this object-oriented approach and reuse of your code to save time. So we have class, let's say my app, and in here this my app is subclass of wx.app, which is a class. So we will define function on init. This function is override the function in wx.app, and this function, so in this function we will override the base function, and we have only message box. So wx.messageBox, let's say the message which is displayed to the viewer will be first app in Python, so and the title will be main app. We will return now false. As I have mentioned, this is simple app. So after creating this part, second part, we should start the third part. This third part is the function which will main loop and reuse this app. So if name equals name, so we have, let's say, soft equals my app, and so soft dot main loop. It's better to return true in the main, and in the constructor we will return false. So it seems enough to run our app, so we will go to this directory and run python1.py. We will see this message box which will appear to the viewer, and it contains the main app which we defined here, simple message, and the first app in Python, which is this message that appears here. When creating OK, this exits from the app. Hello and welcome. This is the second video in our series. In this video, we will create our first frame in WXLS. So, as usual, we will import in WX, and we will first define the frame. So, we have class my frame. So, feel free to adjust this variable or this name as your as you like. So, class my frame will be WX dot frame. So, this is the subclass from WX frame. And we will later define the constructor. So define init of self. It has any frame as usual, has parent, and we have title. So now title is empty. We will fill here. So after that, we will create the constructor. So we have super of my frame. And this cell, so this constructor will be then displayed as parent. It will be have parent and the title. We will title equals title. So the user can reuse this title or this class later. So we may like to add icon to this app self dot icon. This variable, feel free to adjust it. So self.icon is wx.icon, and here in between these brackets you should apply app.bmg. any icon you want to add this to the frame. And self.panel, we have also panel, so self. And feel free also adjusting this variable or the name of this variable as you like. But I will I will name it self.panel. Self.panel equals is wx.panel of self. After that, so this is, I have mentioned earlier, this is the second part, and this is the third part, and in this third part we will define the main app. In this main app we will name it my app inherited or subclass from my app. So we will define on init and self dot frame equals my frame of null. It has, this frame has no parent, and title equals the icon. This is the name of this frame, and self dot frame, we will show it this frame. After that, we will return true with the name of T capital. After that, the final part to finalize this app. So if name equals main, we will have this app. this app. After that, if name equals main, so we have, let's say, software equals my app of false software dot name node. This is complete app. It's better to include, as I have done, include this icon in the same bus or of your app of or you of your app. So we will here include find.png. Feel free to add your icon. So the final part is to run this app. So we will go to this directory, change directory to this app, and we will run Python to the point. There is a run in this app, it says. So the run here is in the finding icon, it has set icon, not icon, set in capital S and I in capital S. So we will run this app Python to the point. This app contains the frame, this frame, and this title, the icon. This title has symbol icon, which we have defined earlier in this line.
Hello everyone and welcome. This is the third video in our series. Now we are going to discuss how to include image into your app. So first we will import only WX, and after that we have a class. To include image into your app, you should define image panel. So we will say we have a class image panel inheritance wx.panel. We will define the constructor, define init of self.parent. So super image panel and self dot init of parent and this constructor defined that this image panel will be parent from a high level component. Let's say this high level component will be a frame. After that we have the bitmap, so we'll define this bitmap in, let's say, photo equal wx.bitmap, and here we will define the icon in find.png. So photo self.bitmap. This image panel have the property of bitmap, so self.bitmap equals wx.static bitmaps of self, and let's say bitmap will be bitmap will be the photo, and here bitmap has in small. The next part is to define that we have a frame. So second, let's add comment here. Second part is to add frame. So we have class my frame inheritance from wx.frame. We will define the constructor for this class, so define init self and parent, and title as moment will be like that, super my frame self dot and yet
parent and title equals title. After that, we will add this panel, which is image panel, to the frame. So self.panel, panel has the property of panel, self.panel equals image panel, which we have defined earlier in this class, image panel. So image panel of self has, so the frame, this frame, my frame, will be parent of this image panel. After that, the final part is to define the app and the main method. We have typed it earlier in previous videos, so I have missed it, and it seems that this app is ready for executing. I have saved it, and it seems better to go to this directory and change directory to this directory. And let's say Python, we will run this app by Python 3.py. So 3.py, we have error in line 3. So the error here, when we make this image panel a subclass of WX panel in WX library, panel WX panel is defined as D capital. So I have saved it and changed it, and let's run this again. We have global image panel defined. So the exception in line 5, image also will be capitalized, and let's run it again, and it should display this symbol app, which has this icon, this image as background, and this image will be static, and it seems static in everywhere. This image includes in, as I have mentioned, in image panel, and this image panel includes in the frame. And this frame is the main part of our app. In the next video, we will talk about binding to events in WXBuy.
Everyone, and welcome. This is the fourth video in our series about creating and discussing how to binding to events in WXBuy. So this is first. This is simple app. We will first import WX. Our apps included when this frame is shown, it creates event, and with it closes it, when this app is closed, it creates event. So we will define on init. Before that, we have class. So we have class my frame. So it seems better to include also the app. So we have class, let's say my app, and this app inheritance from this app, my app, will be subclass from wx.app. We have main function defined on init. And self dot frame equal wx dot frame. The parent is none, and the title will be, let's say this will be the main event. We have also, after creating this main frame, we should add events to this frame. So self.frame.bind to add event to this frame, wx.evtshow. we have function self. This function we will define later, but this name, the name of this function will be self dot on frame show. And also when we close this app, it should when we close this app, it should also have event. So self.frame.bind wx has event when close event. So this event has the name of close or wx.event evt close, and this has also another function which we will define later, and I will type here on close, let on close. So now we will define this function which will be executed when this event will be returned. So define function on frame show, on frame show we have self and have event. The frame equals event dot event object. After that we will print in the command line frame we will make this function reusable, so we will use regular expression. So we will say here the frame dot title, and after this we will skip the event, define on frame exit we have self, which means this function related to this app, and also passing to argument event. We will define the frame or our app or our frame as object. So the frame equals event dot event object, and also we will print here print frame. We will use also regular expression. We will print frame is closing, and here we will print the frame dot title. After that it's much better to skip this event. Define the main function or if name equals main. It's important to verify that only if you run this app with this name, it will be run from this only app, not another file. If name equals main, we will. So we have forget to show this frame. So here we will add comment to show the frame. We will say self.frame.show. self.frame.show, and also return true. It seems it's capital, and after that we have, let's say, soft equals my app. We have my app of argument passing to it false soft dot main loop. It seems this first app is complete. So
Now we are ready to run this. We will run this app by going to the command line and Python for the by so we have run in this.
So you may remember that this function related to the function when which executed when we have this event return. So I have changed this function to be similar to this function. We must verify that the name is equal. After that, I will run this app, and also you should save this and run again. Also, another thing to title in the frame is capital T, and title also is capital T. So our app is ready to run. We will run this by python.core.py, and this will be created. Note in the command line is showing a frame is showing, and also the main event is type. If you click the close red icon, it's closing. So this example showing how to use events in WXPython. In the next video, we will talk about understanding UI in. Hello everyone and welcome. This is video number 5 in our series. Now we are going to discuss hierarchy in WXPython. This will be not fully functional app, but to understand how WXPython is laying out or organizing our components in any simple or complex application. So as usual, we will import WX. First part, we will add here command. First part will be a class myFrame, which inherits from wx.frame, and we will define the constructor, define init self parent, and the title will be now empty. So we can now define the constructor super of my frame. Each frame has constructor of init parent, and title will be title. So this is important or main function of WXPython, that you write your app or your code as reusable. So you can after typing that self.panel equals my panel of self, as I have mentioned, WXPython offers free tools to reuse your code, so you can reuse this copy and paste this function or this class of MyFrame in any other app and build another functions relay on this class. Also, we have a second part. We will add command second part. We have a class my panel wx.panel, define init of self and parent. So the constructor will be super of my panel and self dot init of parent self dot
button wx dot button self
so this has argument label of the label with which will be shown in this button. Let's say push the button. After we have defined this, the only final third part is the app and the main function. So we have written it before many times, so I have missed it, and it seems this app is ready to run. But before that, we will define that we have to a hierarchy of any app frame and behind that or below that, inside that we have panel width, which is part of this frame, and also the app which contains all the components, all the frames, all the panels in this app. So it's ready to run this app. So I am here in the directory on the command line, and we'll run this Python hire.py. This is the name of this file, hire.py. It seems there is shift. So this file is ready to run, but if you run that, you should see push the button in the layout. So this push button is included in the frame, and this frame included in the main app, which has the name of window hierarchy. And that's it for this video. In the next video, we'll explore how to controlling events in WX Python. Hello everyone and welcome. This is video number 6 in our series about drag and drop, supporting drag and drop in WX Python. Many apps allow users to open files by dragging a file from the operating system and dropping it in the application, and also WX Python supports that. This example will show how to set up a drop target to allow handling dragging and dropping files in an application. So this simple application will be a frame and has a multi-text component. And when we drag and drop any file from your system, it should print the name and the directory of this file into your application. So we will, as usual, import WX, and we have class my file drop target. So this my file is this class inherits from WX dot file drop target. And we will define the constructor here, define init of self and target. We will create here the constructor to bar my file drop target. And we will define the target self dot target equals target. So we can later use also use only target, not self dot target. So we will define function also in this level, define on drop file self x y file names for fn in file names. So is that ensure if there is a file, if there is file name or there is a file you have imported, you have typed it You have dragged it and dropped it into your application, is so you can add more files. So we will say self.target.append. We will append to this ticket fn. After that, after we have created that file drop target, we will create class my frame wx.frame, define the main constructor init of self and parent title will be super super my frame and self. You may notice that we have created this constructor many times before. So after that, so we will here create the panel, set the main panel or the main component of this application. So we have now in this add class or text, so self.text equal wx.text control self and style will be wx.te multi-line self.text.append we will add text drag and drop file here. And this is self.text. So that means we have created text and added to this text another text. So we will say that we have drop target. Drop target will be my file drop target of self.text self.text.set drop target drop That means that we have added to this text drag and drop object, and in the final part we will. So in the in this final line, we will say self.text.set drop target drop target. So this is ready to, I will go to this directory and open this directory and run python 3.py. We have this app will be the name of python 2.py. It seems it has error. So this text control T and run again, it has error. Multi. So this in this line wx dot multi line, and let's run it again. Also my file drop target isn't defined. So there were wrong in line number 5. in MISD writing this constructor. So after that, we will run this app by sudo py. It say drag and drop file here. So I will go here and let's say drag and drop this icon to this app. After dragging it, it should work. So after dragging and dropping file is not working. So we will return to our app. So if I run this application, it say drag and drop. If I had I drop this icon, it will. If I drop any icon or any file, it should return the path of this directory and the name of this file. And that was for this video. In the next video, we'll discuss how to accessing the clipboard in WX. After come back, we will start new chapter in our series. So we will talk about common user controls in WX Python. So we will import WX, and we have class. Let's say this class will be my panel, and this class inherits from wx.panel class C class, and we will define the constructor, define init self parent, and we will define the constructor super of my panel self dot init parent. We are going to create three different buttons. To lay out these buttons, we will create sizer. So this sizer will make the control of these buttons. So sizer will be wx.box sizer, wx.horizontal. So we have first button equals wx.button and self dot wx id okay. We have button, we will add this button. After creating this button, we will add sizer dot add, we will add button. Also, we have another button. This second button will be wx.button self, and let's say this label. Let's say this label will be a click here. We will add sizer dot add. The dot add button. We may add icon to this button. So let's say photo will be wx dot bit map. We have let's say arrow dot png in this directory, and the button, this button dot set dot set map. We will stick this photo into this button. So after that, the third step is to add the final button, the third button, which is cancel button. So wx dot button self
and wx dot I d apply. So button dot set post needed, and finally sizer dot add sizer dot add button self dot set sizer
so we will define the sizer to be a property of this panel. After creating this button, so to enhance this this layout, we should create event. So self dot bind to wx dot evt button self dot on self dot on button. So the final the remaining step is to define and write this self on button this on button function. So we will define on button function which has self and event as parameters. We have, let's say, fr equal event dot object. We have event dot e event dot event object. After that, we will print button has been pushed. We will use regular expression. So fr dot let's say label, and here is the regular expression like that. Remember that we set os needed to a button. So if fr dot get os needed, so we will bring action required. So these labels. The final step is to skip add the skip event event dot skip, and remember that skip has the S capital and event like that. That's enough for the panel. So after that, the remaining part is to create the frame and the app. I have this the frame and the app. You may have your time to copy it or write it into your app. We have created and write it before more and more times. It's a simple frame and app. It seems enough to write or open this app. So we will go to this directory and change directory to that. And now it's the time to Python 1.py to run this app. It seems to have attributes error that here wx have button and wx have button. So after running the app, it say there is wrong in line. So it seems enough. We have there was error here, and error in button add will be at capital set S capital get here G capital.
So it's enough, and let's run this app. It's running successfully. If we push the OK button, it will run event. So, and also when clicking the click here button, it will bind to event click here has been pushed and apply action required to these labels. Remember that action required to these labels refer to get authentication here. And it seems that this app is fully functional and works successfully with the command line. You can alter and change these events as you like if you want to open new GUI or a new window or a new something, or as you like, or this event will be in a form, so you want to enter to system or something like that. That's enough for this video. In the next video, we'll discuss how to create more buttons and enhanced versions of buttons, as well as offering options in the next video. Hello everyone and welcome. This is Kenneth Hami and this is video number 3 in SQLite, and now we are going to discuss how to insert data into table in our database which we have created previously. Previously we have discussed the create and connecting to database. So now we are going to discuss how to insert data into this database by or into our table by using Java commands. So first we'll import java.sql.everything, and as usual we will start public static void main string arguments, and we have as usual connection, so we will say this connection to be null. And also we have statement, so we will say that we have a statement, and this statement will call this variable or this object is steam and assign to it value of null. Because we are going to connect with database, so we must use try and catch. In the try we will start. So we will define the connection parameters for our database. So we have class dot for name, and inside that we will define our connection, which is org.sqlite.gdbc, and denote that gdbc all in caps. Be sure that no spacing in class. It seems that the class with capital C. So now in the first line we have defined our driver, and next we in this line, line number 16, we have defined that we have connection to this database. And you to be sure that no repeated values will be inserted into your database, so you should c.set auto commit to false, and that will ensure that you will not insert repeated values into your database. You must after that you should print the statement that you have connection successful. So successfully, let's say successfully connected, let's say successfully connected to this database, and that's enough for this line. After we have connection with this database, we must determine how to insert data in this database. So we must define this steam object, steam equals c dot create statement, after that we must determine or define this SQL command which make the rule of inserting data. So we will start by string SQL equals this is uniform
SQL command. If you have any knowledge about SQL or MySQL commands, you must know that in, if you want to insert data, you should write this command insert, and be sure that all in caps insert into, let's say, data. So I have watched this video until I create and write this SQL command. After that, we must say that steam.execute. We have steam objects, so steam.execute. Here we have steam object.execute update of this SQL command that have the ability to inserting data by executing this SQL command. After that, c.commit to save these results, and we don't have need this connection anymore, so c.close. And we must also, after the connection to steam.close, we must close also the statement. In the exception, we will print a regular error. In this error, we will print that e.get class dot get name so e.get class dot get name, and here e.get message. So we want here to print get class C capital. So we will print the message with in which the error, and printing it to the user. And after that, we must exit from this program. So system.exit of zero. After that, after all, we have finished the inserting data successfully. We should point the user that he have inserting data successfully. So we will print that in a statement. So system.out.println recorded successfully. Inserted or something like that. Inserted. So now let's create or run this class. So open database successfully. If we have opened this project and run the insert, so we will we have exception in no such table called users. If we in this users, we let's say company. If we run this again, open the database, we must run in project the insert. Before that, let's make sure 6 values for 5 column. So we have inserted more values than which are in the table. So here was more value, more empty value. Let's run that again and run the insert command. We should see this recorded successfully inserted. So before you run this, you should make sure that you have this table already into your database, which has the name company. If you haven't it, you should create it previously and do this class again. After that, you should see this message. We have firstly connected to this database, and secondly, we have this recorded successfully inserted. So we must make sure that we have inserted data in this database. So I am here in DB browser for SQLite. You should install it if you haven't. I have included this URL into the description of this video. if you have, if you want to make sure that data already existed into and you have successfully inserted data, so you should browse, make sure that you have a company, you have company a table only in this database. If you want to browse data, you should have this ID, which is unique for this database. All your tables, all the row in your table will be classified to this ID. After that, you should see the name, which is string, and the age, which is integer, and the address, which is string also, and the salary, which is real. So here in this class, I have created more statements and more SQL commands to insert more data in this database. So we must run this to execute these commands and record it successfully inserted. If we are here and refreshed, we must open this database again. So after I have browsed my database in SQL browser, I see these more values which I have created previously. So that was for inserting data in this SQLite. In the next video, we will explore how to update values or change values or change rows values and rows in this SQLite browser. Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Kanotama and this is video number 4 in our mini series about linking Java to SQLite. In this video, we are going to discuss how to selecting and showing data which is already existed into your database. So first, we will import java.sql.everything, which this package has the interfaces that we must use for connecting to any database. As usual, we'll start a main method, public static void main string arguments. As usual, we'll define that we have connection is to be null, and also we have a statement. Let's say it define variable of a name of null and a connection. Let's make sure that we have typed it correctly. Connection. After that, we will start try and catch statement. So here is the try catch. So first, we will build a connection for this database. So we have class .for name and define the. So we will define gdbc org .sqlite .gdbc, which has the driver. Which is the name of the driver for connecting, and also we have c.driverManager. So we have C, we'll define for this C driver manager C in a small, which you have defined correctly, which refers to the connection. So C driver manager. Driver manager dot get connection to this database, to this good connection, and in the method of get connection we'll define the parameter, which is, so we have here GDBC and SQLite, and here the name of our database. So we have users.db. As I've mentioned, C in small c, which refers to this connection. To make sure that there is no repeated value into your database, and make sure that if you inserted a command, you make sure that you haven't multiplied any command. So we will say that c.set auto commit to false, and that make sure of that, and after that we must system.out.print, and they must print that we have opened database successfully. And this we should make here comment. Let's say this is the first step, and let's say open here, and let's say after that we have this is the second step. The second step is to selecting values from your database. Selecting value is very simple, but you should first define your statement. So steam equals c dot create statement. Create statement. So we have result set. When it comes to showing or selecting values from your database, you must define this object, which is result set. I will say that result set is to be, let's say this name will be RS. So RS is this name of object of result set will be steam.execute query. And here is SQL command, which will define selecting, and make sure you have in activated caps lock into your keyboard, and type select everything which is star from, let's say we have table company, and close this line. So we will say while we have rs dot next. This rs has next values. This result has make you that means result set is one row into your database. So while RS, while result set, while there is row into your database, you must define or must you show these values. If you remember, we have five columns into this table. We have ID and age and name and address and salary. So we will define five variables for each value in each column. So integer id equals rs dot get string to dot get integer to dot get integer of the string which is id. This is the first column, and also we have string name equals rs dot get string of this is name, and third column is integer age equals rs dot get integer of age, and fourth column is equal string address, which is address equals rs dot get string of, let's say, address. Make sure you have typed these values correctly, and float salary equals rs dot get salary to rs dot get salary of salary, and close this. After float in f capital F and to dot get float of dot get float, make sure you have typed this correctly, and also float float. After that, you must print this one. So system dot out dot print line, we will print that we have id and here is the id, and we must you may save a lot of time by copying this line and paste it more times. Here is another value. We have the name, so we have name, and we have also address, let's say age first, and after that we have address, and after that we have salary. We will here type the name variable, and here is the age, and here is the address, and here
is the salary. Final element. After each record, after each row, you should print empty line. So system.out.println, let's say, will be like that. So this line will be separator between each record. Between each print, between each record, this will be printed an empty line. After that, you should system.error.println e.getClass.getName of this error name. After that, e.getMessage to notify the user of the error message, or to notify us of the error or the exception. If there is exception, you should system.out, you should close system.exit of zero value to exit from. And after while statement, don't forget to close the result set and close the steam and close the connection. So let's make that. So result set dot close. Make sure that you type it correctly. So result set dot close and close that. Also we have connection. So also we have result steam dot close. And also we will close that connection. C.close like that. Finally, there is only one thing. We must notify the user by message. So let's say operation done successfully. Before that, system.out, let's say this will be a separator like that. Let's say this will be a separator for us. And let's run this select class. There is exception missing database. So select will be like that. E capital select. So you make sure that you typed the command correctly. And run again this class. You should find that's good. This is fun project that we have these values typed correctly and nicely has been presented each row, each values into your database. This is the first record, this is the first value, and this is the second row, this is the second value, and this is another third row, and this is the final and the fourth row into your database, and finally there is a message output for you. And that's it for selecting values and selecting rows from to your database. In the next video, we'll define how to edit and update values into your value, into your rows. See you in the next video. All right, welcome back. This is Kamil Tohami, and I am now here in video number 5 in this series, mini series about SQLite and linking SQLite to Java. In this video, I am going to discuss how to update and modify values in this table, which is company in our database, which is have the name of users. So let's start by creating new file. Let's say the name of this file will be modify or update. Let's delete this default, and as usual, we will start by import java.sql.everything. This SQL package has all methods and all interfaces that we want for linking this class to database. So public, as usual, we have public static void main string arguments, and we have connection c equals null, and we have statement. Let's say this will be steam, also will be null. So after that we have try catch statement, and
we will define that we have bridge to this database through the Java bridge. So we will define class .for for name org.sqlite.jdbc, and after that we have so this line will define that we have driver and define the name of our driver SQLite to GDBC driver, and after that we will say that C equals driver manager dot get connection dot get connection of this database, so GDBC SQLite, and here we will define the name of our database. Our database has the name of users dot db. After that we will create state, and to make sure that we haven't and will not any time create any repeated statements and repeated values and repeated rows in this value. So there is method that take care of that, which has the name of set auto commit to false. After that, it's the time to make a print out statement, system to audit print line, connected, let's say connected successfully to database, and here is connected. After that, we will update row in this database. Updating it, we will say that steam.create, so we must create statement, so steam.create statement, so c equals c.create statement, and we have now defined the statement, and we have the string SQL, and this SQL command is equal to update company where so we will set salary will be let's say 12 where ID will be 1. So this command, if you have any knowledge about SQL commands, so to updating anything or any row in your database, you must say that update company and set salary to something where ID. Here you can find where name, where age, and it's better to define rows by ID. So it's better to define or modify them. After that, you should executing this query or this SQL command. So steam have a method for that which we have discussing earlier, dot which is execute update of this SQL command, and let's close this line. After that, after this execution, we have the ability to save these values, so we will not lose them or lost them by leaving this class. So C document, make sure that you have saved your results. You have the choice to close this class and see them in a browser, but it's better to showing it the difference between these SQL commands in this Java class. So as we have made in the select Java class, we have make result set and printed the results. So I will copy all these lines and paste them in the update to save a lot of time. And to save a lot of time, I have copied and pasted these lines, which has the functionality to executing and printing all values in all rows into your database. And make sure you have closed the result set, and you have closed the Steam object, and you have closed the connection. And in the catch statement, as usual, we have printing the name of the class under the name of the message and exit. If there is exception, you will exit obligatory from this class. Finally, we will print that operation done successfully. Before we make anything, you must say that ID1 has salary of 4,000. But after execute and running this update, so it's done successfully, and in ID number one, salary became 12, not 4,000. So it successfully updated this database. Let's say see that in and refresh. Let's refresh, and that's it. It's updated this ID, which is has the name of a name Kamel and age 242. And update this salary. Let's make another change. Let's say will make salary became, let's say, 3,000, any number, and when ID equals, let's say, 3, it will be executing. So let's update that and run. If we run this file, it's not to say that operation successfully. Good, nice. It should then you should it should running in the output. That it in ID number 3 it became 3,000. In this DB browser, you should, and if you refresh your database, you should see this 3,000. And let's make another change. Let's say we will update company set. Let's say this salary will, or this age, not salary, let's say that age will be, let's say, 50, where ID will be 2. And let's run this again, run this project by running this update file. And that's it. If you came to your DB browser, you will see that Muhammad, which has the ID number 2, has age of 50. Let's try to update the salary of Muhammad. So in we will update salary SLRY, and let's say salary will be 252525, any number, and ID will be 2. So to save that, we'll run update statement and refresh that in this database. And that's it. That we defined and edited this row and salary of Muhammad in this database. And that's it for updating values in your database. In this video, this will be the last video in our mini course about linking Java to SQL, and we'll discuss how to delete rows from your database. Alright, welcome back. This is Kanutam, and this is final video in our series about linking Java to SQLite. In this video, we will try to delete rows from our database by using Java class. So we will try to make new class by saying delete. So in this class, we will delete rows or delete values from your database. So we will first import java.sql package, everything in this SQL, and we will say public static void. Public static void means string arguments, and we have connection as usual. Connection C will be null, and we have statement stem to be null. And make sure you have typed statement correctly. And the connection also, make sure you have typed it correctly. After that, we have try and catch statement as usual. We have try and catch statement. In the try catch, we have a clause
dot for name, and here is the name of our GDBC driver. We have org dot SQLite dot GDBC, and make sure that all in caps. After that, you have C dot driver, driver manager, which is a class into your SQL package. Driver manager dot get dot get dot get connection of this database. So you have SQLite GDBC, and this is the name of your database. So I have users.db. This is the name of our database. If you have anything other, you should type this. And see, also C is this object, this name. So we have C in small. And after that, we must make sure that you haven't input any repeated values into your database. So we have C.setAutoCommit to false. Either than true, you have false. And after that, you should write the usual command that connection made successfully, or you can type any other message. After that, we will create steam object. So steam equals C dot create statement, and we have a SQL command. So we will define it as string. String SQL will be delete. Let's say if you have any familiar knowledge with SQL, you should know that all SQL commands all caps are in capitalized. So we will delete from company. So we have table in this database. We also any database. Let's say these users have many tables. Any H tables has rows and columns. So when we make a delete, we delete full row. We should delete all in caps, delete from company where, let's say, where ID will be 2. We must execute this statement. So steam have function execute. So steam has function execute update of this SQL command. And after that, you must save this result. You must save this command by saying c.commit. So c.commit. You have the option to go to SQLite browser and see the changes or see this in your console. We have made this before, so I will save a lot of time by copying this from this class and printing it directly in this new delete class. After that, we have system.error e.get class dot get name. We will print the name of this class, and finally we will print the message which will appear to when we have any exception, so like that, and that's fine. Before we must exit, if there is exception, we must exit from our program. So we'll say system.exit of zero value. Finally, after that, we must print that we have system.out.println. System.out.println. Let's say operation done successfully. And that's nice. It seems complete. Before we done the run of this class, we must go to this. And let's say we will delete this third row. So we'll delete this third row, which has the ID of 3. And that's, let's say, we will delete from company where ID will be 3. And we'll go to this project and run this delete class. So we have no suitable driver. So the exception here in this line.
So GDBC first, GDBC first SQLite. And this is the right, the right name of this class. So if this, we run this again by shift, if no such table company, and also company in wrong. So we have company, C-O-M-B-A-N-Y. And let's run this again by running this delete class. And it must say connection made successfully. And finally, it has deleted the third row. Successfully, we have deleted third row. And if we have refreshed this database, we must, this third row has disappeared from this database. And that's what we want. If we want also to delete this fourth ID, this fourth row which has the name of Muhammad and age of 22, and these values, these data, we must go to go again, and where ID equals 4, we will delete all the row from this company table which occurs in users.db database. If we go and run this from NetBeans, it will connection successfully, and also we have only, let's expand that, we have only this ID and this ID, which means two rows into your database. If we have refreshed that in your SQLite, and that's what we want, two only rows into your database. And that's it, we have made successfully CRUD operations with SQLite, which refers to create, read, update, delete. I will put all links for all codes and the project in the description of this video. If you like this mini course, subscribe for more mini courses. You can request for any course or wait for other mini courses on Altohemy channel on YouTube. See you later. Good luck. Alright, welcome back. This is Kamatan from Simplify.com. Today we are going to discuss very exciting problem in WX Python, which are creating more buttons. This is the interface which we are going to build in this lesson. It contains two toggle buttons and also the blade button, which is has been added in the recent version, version 3 in WX Python. And this is another exciting button, which is drop down button. You may need it a lot into your programs. And also this is command line button. If you have using Windows 7 anymore, you should use this in, if you are going to install let's say .NET framework. So this is the interface which we are going to build in this lesson. Firstly, we will make the panel which contains all buttons in this lesson. Enough talking, let's start coding this interface. So this is the file which you are going to coding in. So we will import WX, and also to use the functionality of palette button. So we will import WX.lib, which refers to library, and palette btn as, let's say, plate. And this is second line show. We will made this, we will make here, I will add comment. So we will make here a panel, the main panel, or and the main core of our program. So we have class, I will say my panel. You can add any name you want. So this class inherits from wx.panel, which is a class in WX library. And we have, we should after that make the constructor and define our constructor. So we have define init and self, which refers to this lesson. If you have any knowledge about object oriented in Python, you should know what the meaning of self, and know also that parent is the parent of this panel. So panels originally included in frame or high level GUI. So after that, we have the super to override the main method in my panel. So we will override the main panel, and also self. Here is self dot and yet of parent. Now we have successfully make the constructor and override the main method. As usual, in layout organizing, we will use box sizer. So we will define that we have box sizer vertical sizer equals wx dot box sizer, and that inherits from wx dot vertical. And also we have a vertical sizer. This is vertical sizer, and this is horizontal sizer. So sizer equals wx dot box sizer wx dot horizontal. We will add this sizer into the vertical sizer. So vertical sizer contains a lot of horizontal rows. Each row is defined as horizontal box sizer, and then vertical sizer dot add, we will add inside it one row which is sizer, and make sure of add is small caps and also vertical sizer as like that. Now we are going to define our toggle button. So we have a toggle equal toggle, we'll define toggle equal wx dot toggle button inherits from self, which is contained inside this class, and also have the argument of label. We will define label for this, let's say toggle, let's say toggle one, and after that we will add this button to the sizer, which is horizontal sizer. So let's make sure of button is typed correctly, and we will add here toggle t-o-o toggle dot add. We will add here the first, so we will add the two sizer dot add toggle t-o-g-l-e. After that we will define another toggle button. So we have toggle, let's say 2 equal wx dot toggle button, have two parameters. First is self and the second is label, let's say toggle 2. And we will add as usual sizer dot add this toggle T-O-O-G-L-E. After that, we will define that we have blade button. So we have blade equals blade button, blade B-T-N. We have here imported this class as blade. So we will define it as blade only. And so dot this blade class or this blade package has a blade class. So dot blade, make sure that blade in caps, all in caps, that means it capitalized, dot blade button inherits from self, and label will be let's say a blade button, and that's cool, very cool to add this blade button, and you will see another interesting results by adding this blade button. So after that we will add this blade. So we have to add this as usual to our interface. After that we have another blade button, but we will, this new blade button will be menu, and we as you have seen in the beginning of this video, we have a blade button with menu, which if you have clicked this button, you will see another menu. So that we must define another blade. Let's say blade 2 will be blade which has blade button. And inherits from self, and the another parameter is, will let's say menu, button menu. Let's say button menu. That's nice. And so So we have menu. So menu will be wx.menu and inherit it from, let's say this menu will be action menu. And after that we have to add menu.append wx.id of open, and this label will be open it, and another menu object, another menu, menu.append with is function in menu wx.id all in all. Make sure that you have typed it in all in caps, so id.id close. And also after that you must type the label which will appear in this user interface. So let's say close now. And finally you will set this menu to the blade2 variable. So blade2.set set will be like that, is capital and menu, set menu to menu. Finally we will add this menu to the sizer, which is horizontal sizer. So sizer.add, and we will add like that blade 2. Finally we have another command, part 2 is the command button. So the next step is to define that we have command command button. So we have command CAMD, command, so command link will be wx.command link button and inherits from self, and main label will be click, let's say here, anything. And another argument which we must add to this command link button is the node. So node also appears in the button. So we have in the node let's say, are you sure you want to exit the program. After that we will, so we have command link button, we have defined it, so we will add this to the vertical sizer. So vsizer.add, we will add cmd link, and after that self.set sizer to vsizer vertical sizer, and also self.bind. So we have finished our GUI. So after that we will, next step is to define our events, and events which are related to buttons. So we have only two events, event when we toggle button and event when we make or click on drop down button. So self.bind to add event, we have already events which is defined in WX library. So wx.evt toggle button and self.onToggle. This is the first event, and another event is self.bind, the event when we click on the button. So EVT all in caps, EVT all in caps and button. So we have another function which is self.onButton. Don't worry, we will add these methods here. So now it's the time to define these methods so our events is complete and it should work successfully when we clicked on button or on so this event will be fired successfully when we clicked on any button. So we have defined on toggle button on toggle a class self and event. So button will be event dot toggle event dot toggle object. So button is event object. So event this event has event object. And after that, we will print a message to the console when this button is clicked. So we will print, and here, let's say button is clicked. So button toggle button was pushed. And we add this regular expression. So we'll button dot label and make sure that label in capital L. After that, we must skip this event. So, and before that, we must add the state of this button, which is clicked on or clicked off, which is on or off. So toggle state will be regular expression of this. And here is button dot value, and we have completed this first function. The second function is on button, which inherits from as usual event and self. As the first, we will define that we have button object, so we have button equals event dot event object, and we will print message. So this regular expression. So here we will print a message. Print was pushed. Button dot label, and we will skip this event. So we have successfully written and coding the main part of this program. This is simple buttons, and I will not waste a lot of time copying the main parts of the frame and the app, as we have written it in any more times previously in previous videos. So I have copied and pasted it from another previously files, and now it's the time to run this file and make sure that all work successfully and all work correctly. So I have saved this button and run. So I am now in the bus, and make sure that you have opened your command line and then change directory to this bus and run this file by type the Python buttons. You have buttons.py, and it should say that you have in this line, you have an error. You go again to your command line, and after you have changed this add to a capital, so you run again and you see another global name toggle isn't defined. So after I have changed my file, I have seen that I have a whole bunch of exceptions and wrong errors in my file. Here in bind I have error, and also in min label L capital, all other wrongs in this type from this type, which is capitalized L or something like that. Add also in a capital append, here is some wrong. So make sure that you have typed this file correctly, and don't worry, I will upload it and put the link in the description of this video. And let's refer and return to our command line and type this. Let's close it firstly and let's say Python buttons dot py to run this program. So we have here toggle, which is the first button, and also the second button. Here is the blade button, and here is the drop down button, and here is the click here, which is command link button. Alright, after I have finished this event test, I have changed value to be capital V and label to be capital L and skip to be is capital. Make sure of that. After I have launched this program in toggle, you see that true and false. Toggle is button. All events are working correctly, and also add the blade button, it worked correctly. Pushed. Blade button was pushed, and also in the drop down menu, when you clicked on this drop down menu, you see pushed button menu was pushed. And also in open it doesn't work because we didn't add any events for open it and close it. If you have clicked in this command link button, you see this. Are you sure you want to exit the program was pushed, which is the name of this command link button. And that's it for this video. In this video, we'll explore new topics in WX Python. See you later in next video. Alright, welcome back. This is Kenton from SimplifySeries.com. Today we are going to discuss how to drawing and making checkboxes in WX Python. So our program will be simple. It contains main checkbox and another two checkboxes and only one event. So we will start by importing WX, and we have class panel. So we have class my panel, which inherits my panel, which inherits from wx.panel, and this we will define the constructor of this init function. Define init and self and parent. So after that we will override the main method as usual, so super of parent and self, super of parent and self dot init of parent to override the main method. After that, make sure that you typed self correctly. So we will create our first check. We will define firstly the layout. So we have one only vertical sizer. So vertical sizer will be wx.box sizer, and take a parameter wx.vertical all in caps. That means that inherits properties of vertical sizer, and make sure you have typed the name of this variable correctly, vertical sizer. And after that, vertical sizer, this is the main layout for our program. So we have the first checkbox. I will name it self.all because it will control the all other checkboxes, and the self.all will be wx.checkbox. Have this parameter self, which means these panels will be parent will be included inside another frame or another high level component. So self.all equals wx.checkbox, and label we will define that we have label, let's say all checks, and final. So we have style, so style will be wx.chk 3state, and after that we will add this checkbox to the vertical sizers to our layout. So vertical sizer dot add self dot all will add dot add self dot all, and make sure that you have type add with capital A. And after that we will add another two options, another two checkbox. So self.option2 width is the name of this checkbox. So wx.checkbox and inherited from self. Make sure that you have some self correctly, and we have label also will be option one. So when we add this vertical sizer dot add, when we have this self dot option one, we have the functionality to add another parameters to adjust this appearance of self dot option one. So we will add border, which is like padding in HTML components, and we have also the flag. So the flag will be wx.left and left all in caps. We must type it in the right place. So here in the flag will be wx.left. That's nice. And another border will be 10 pixels, which means padding around this option. This checkbox will be adding padding around 10 pixels. Another component, another checkbox as usual as the main command, self.option2 wx.checkbox. This inherits from self and has the label of option 2. That's nice. We will make that vertical sizer dot add. We will add self dot option one, option two, and we have the parameters, another parameters with flag wx dot another left. Let's say that has the label of the have border another 10 pixels. Make sure that you have typed the border correctly, like that. After we have created these two more options, which are checkboxes like that, but we must add the events. So self.setSizer to be vertical sizer, and also self.bind to be wx dot so wx library. Wx Python have already defined functions when we checkbox or you check or uncheck checkbox. So this all in caps, wx dot check event check. So make sure you have activated your caps lock event dot check. And the functions which related to event.checkbox will be self.onCheck. After that, we will define our functions. So we will save a little time and define one function for all checkboxes, as all checkboxes from the same type. So we will define onCheck. Has this function, because this is related to event, so it will be inherited from self and event. Make sure that you have typed event correctly. So we will define our object. So check equals event dot event object, and make sure that you event is E capital and object is O capital. So if it check this object is in self.all, we will say that self.option1.value will be check.value. That means, let's write that and I will define what that means from these lines. So if we in the check or the first check, which is all has the name of self.all. So if we have checked it, it will check the others. If we have checked unchecked it, it will uncheck the others. So the all, the first one, is control the two other checkboxes. And if we checked another checkbox, which is the child, the small checkbox, so it will be fired another event. So else controls, else statements controls the event when it's checked on another child of the third or the two. So I have paused this video until I write these lines. We have values, which is the list of value of option one and option two. And if these values, so if we have checked or selected all the one of two of these values, it will check the parent. If we haven't checked any of these values, it will uncheck the parent. If we have unchecked, this will be undetermined. Finally, we will. You remember that we have defined and written this frame class and app class many times previously, so I will not waste a lot of time copying and writing this, but I have copied and pasted it now. So it's the time to run this program. You mean that it's not completed program, but to learn, and you, if in your program you add this all to your main program. So we have here exception right after I have run my program. So if I have clicked or I checked the first main checkbox, it will select all. If I unselect this first one, it will uncheck all options. And if I selected only one option, either option one or option two, it will set all selected to undetermined. If I selected another one, so it will be set all selected to all checked. And this is how to create and build checkboxes in WXVine. I hope this lesson will be helpful for you. For any questions, feel free to add comment into this lesson. I will also link I will also upload the link of this code in the description of this video. See you later in the next video. Hello everyone and welcome. This is another WX Python tutorial. We are going now to make control text, which memorize your previously entered text. If you have any knowledge about, or if you have previously experience with this Sublime or any code editor, you must see, let's say import WX, you must see that if you have typed W, it will remember previously entered keywords you have entered into your file. So we will make this text editor. It will be simple, just remember the last entries. And let's start by coding it, by defining this. So we have text control inside panel. So firstly, we will define our text control. So class memory text control. And so this class inherits from wx.text control. So we'll define the constructor of this class, define init of self and parent. After that, we will make super function, super memory text control and self dot init of parent. So the main idea of memorize last entries or last text. So every text we will add this to a list. So we will define a list. So self dot me more is equal set and self dot bind wx has already event for that event kill focus event evt kill focus so this event in has been previously defined in wx Python and you have lambda function which event self dot self dot memorize so this function will be executed every time so lambda function with every time we have focused on every keyword it will fire this event and call memorize function the second line is will be self dot bind wx dot event wx dot event evt set focus and make sure that set focus will be all in caps and the related function for this event will be self dot on update complete list on update complete list so the remaining part is to define these functions so we will define memorize function which has the ability to memorize every last entries so self define memorize of self if self dot value then self dot memorize we have this list we will add this self dot value that means if every word every previously entered keyword will be added to this list after that we must determine on update complete list so we must determine on update complete list this define on update complete list of self inherits from have two parameters self and event so this event and self so self dot auto complete of list self dot memories and we must skip this event it's a good practice to define forget method so I will say define forget self dot memorize dot clear if you have any previously experience with Python to clear all the values in a list so you must to delete all values in list you must input this clear function after we have successfully make our memory text control which is enhanced text control we must determine our done so I will say define my panel inherits from wx.panel which means that this class is a subclass of wx.panel so we will define dot in define so we'll define init so the next step is to define our panel so define init is the constructor of this class so define init of make two parameters the first is self and the second is the parent parameter and after that we have super function which override the function in the main class our first parameter is my panel and the second is self dot init and I am sure you have saved these lines because we have typed it in many times previously. In our app, we have only the layout is vertical, and we have only two text control. So we will define my layout. So we have I have vertical sizer equals wx dot box sizer wx dot vertical first. I have field one equal wx dot box dot box sizer, and it will be horizontal, so horizontal. And another field one, this box sizer, I will add to it label, so field one dot add, and make sure that add is capitalized A. We will add the wx dot static text, which means it's a label, and we must determine that it contains in this panel. And another argument is the label. This argument will be, let's say, field one. After we have creating our labels, we must create text control. So text control, let's say TEX will be memory text control of cell. So after that, we will add field one dot add this text. Finally, we will add vertical sizer. Vertical sizer dot add, we will add this field one. We will maybe repeat or copy these lines because we have two fields. Let's say it will be field 2 and field 2 dot add label of 2 to save a lot of time, repeated and writing this anymore, and field 2. After that, you must set sizer of whole your app as a sizer. So self dot set sizer is capital and is of V sizer, and that's make control of our program. If you remember, the main part, the remaining part is to define these classes, which is the class of my frame and the class of my app. I will not waste a lot of time writing these classes because this is main part of our app, and we have writing it many times previously. So I will skip this step and coming to my command line. And so I will change directory to this directory and will run this file python control.py. It seems error here is invalid syntax. And this is the final app which we must make. This is the first text control. Let's say So in the first box, I will type Python and tab to the second box. Let's say I will write WX Python, and it seems work correctly as Google search box. It remembers the previously added keyword. Let's say it will be Python or something like tkinter, and let's say module, and let's say tkinter. It must, let's say, module. So we must, in the first part, we must clear this. So if we say Python, it seems work correctly as Google search. And that's it for this lesson. In this lesson, we will explore new topics in WX Python. See you later in the next video.